Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video, I'll be showing you that how you can implement the bottom navigation view in this social media app using Firebase. Fine guys, so as you can see on the screen that this is a bottom navigation view and this is for profile, and if I will click on it, so this is for question, this is for request, and this is for home. Fine, so guys, this is a fragment, different fragments. It is changing when I'm clicking this icons. So today in this tutorial, I'll be showing you that how can we implement this in our social media app. So guys, without wasting time, let's start. So guys, for implementing bottom navigation view, what we have to do first thing is simply go to this design, and here guys, in this palette, we have to search bottom navigation view, and here we have this. So simply drag it, and now it is saying to add a dependency material for implementing it. So click on the button OK. So guys, it will automatically add the dependency, and then we will be able to implement bottom navigation view. And now it is done. Fine. So again, go back to this split section, and then guys, we will change this parent layout to relative layout. Fine guys, then after this, here you can see that we have this bottom navigation view, but we have to make it wrap content with match parent. Height will be wrap content, then ID will be bottom underscore nav. Fine, parent align bottom, and we will pass true. Then background color will be Android white color. Fine guys, then item icon tint, and that will be Android black color. Done. So guys, after this, I have to remove this button because that was a temporary button for signing out. We are not going to implement it for a long time. Fine guys. So after this, here what we have to do is we will use a frame layout, and that will be match parent and also match parent. Fine. And then gravity will be ID will be frame underscore layout, and then layout above, and that will be ID bottom nav. Fine guys, then close it. So after this guys, what we have to do is we have to create a menu file for bottom navigation view. So simply click on this resources, then new, and then here directory, and that will be for menu. So give it name menu. So here you can see that we have this directory. So inside it guys, we have to create a menu resource file, and we will give it name bottom underscore menu. Enter. And now you can see that guys, we have this menu file. And now guys, here you can see that I have imported some drawables from some vector assets. So here you can see that this is for email. So this is for rate review, this is for queue, this is for person, this is for home. So guys, make sure you import this before implementing it, and you can get it from here. Click on this drawable, then new, and then vector asset. Fine. So I have imported all these vector icons from here, so you can get all of these from here. Fine guys. So just making this tutorial short, I'm skipping this process. So guys, after this, now we have drawables, we have to create items here. Fine guys. So first of all, simply write item, and that is going to be title. Title will be for profile, and then icon will be person, and then show as always, show is action always, and then ID will be profile underscore bottom. Fine guys, then simply close it. So after this, I will copy it, control plus C, and then guys, we will paste it 4 times. Yes, because we need it 4 times. Fine guys, then after this, we will change its name and ID one by one. So this one is for ask, so this time here we will give the text ask, and drawable will be rate review. Fine guys, and ID will be ask bottom, and this time for third one it will be for request. Here we will show the requests. Fine, so the drawable will be queue. Fine guys, and then ID will be queue. You may be thinking that why I'm giving this name, because it is the name of this drawable, that's why. And then guys, this one is for home. Here we will retrieve the posts of all the users. Fine guys, so here we can simply write home, and its ID will be also home bottom. Simply write home bottom. Fine guys, so now you can see that we have these four icons. So if now it's time to go back in this main activity, and here guys we have to give the menu, and that will be menu, and it is going to be Android bottom menu. Fine guys, so now you can see that we have this. So guys, now as you can see that we have this bottom navigation view, and now we have four icons. This is for person, this is for asking, this is for request, this is for home, and you can see that this is our activity main dot under XML file. So guys, if I will run this app, and I want to show you that how it will look. So here you can see that the activity is launched and it is splash screen we did in previous tutorial. So guys, here you can see that we have this main file. So as you can see that it is working pretty fine. So guys, after this we will create some XML file for fragments, because we have to implement fragments. So when we will click on the item, so it will change the fragments. Fine guys, so first of all I will create fragment one, enter, and here guys what you can do is you can give here a text view, and that will be match parent, height will be wrap content, text size, and the text will be, that is just for demo, for showing you. So I will give text is profile, and text size will be 50 sp, then close it. Fine, and then simply click on it, then add tools, missing constraint. Fine guys, so that is just for demo. So after this simply copy this fragment, and we have to create three more. Ctrl+V, and this time we will give it name fragment 2, enter, and we will change the text to, it is for asking questions, so you can say question, then simply close it and close this one also, and after this again creating third one, and its name will be third, and text will be, we will give text, this is for requests. Fine, then close it, and then last one, this is for home, so you can give four, and we'll give the text, that will be home. Fine guys, so now we have four fragments, so it's time to create fragment class. So simply click on this package, new Java class, and name will be fragment one, it is for fragment one, and then we will extends fragment. Fine guys, then inside it we will use on create view, so simply on create view. So now you can see that we have this on create view. Fine guys, so here we have to remove this return line, and instead of it we will write is view, then view equals to inflator dot inflate or dot layout dot fragment one, and then we will pass container, then for attaching to root false, then semicolon. Fine guys, and then we have to return that view, return view semicolon. So here, fine guys, so after this you have to copy this fragment, Ctrl+C, and you have to paste it three more times for other fragments. So fragment 2, then OK, and you have to change this fragment 2. Fine, then simply paste it again, and this time we will give it name fragment 3. Fine, change it to fragment 3, and then close it, and it is for fourth, so we will give it name fourth, and also the file fourth. Done guys, so Now we have 4 fragments, so it's time to code in mainActivity.java that how we will handle this bottom navigation view. Fine guys, first of all come inside this bottom navigation view, and here guys we will write is bottom navigation view and then bottom navigation view equals to find view by id r dot id dot bottom nav then semicolon then bottom navigation view dot set on navigation item selected set on navigation item selected listener and here we will pass on nav. So now it is showing error. So guys, we will remove this error in just few seconds. So after this, what here you have to write is so guys, here after this on nav, you can see that it is showing error, but it will be removed. I will remove it in just few seconds. So after this guys, here you have to write private and then bottom navigation view dot on item selected on navigation item selected listener fine and simply write on nav equals to new on navigation item selected listener fine. So this time what we can do is that we have to handle it when user will click on it. Let me delete it. Fine. So guys, here what we will do is simply write return true and then semicolon. Yes, so now we can code. So here you have to write is fragment then selected equals to null semicolon and then we will use switch statement. So switch then item because our menu item is item dot get item id. We will check that case if case our dot id dot profile bottom. So if it is profile bottom, so what we will do, we will open the fragment selected equals to new fragment one semicolon then break and after this you have to copy this control plus c and then you have to paste it 3 times and now we have 4. So it's time to change the id one by one. So I will change second one is for ask bottom and fragment will be 2. Then third one is for request queue bottom and fragment will be 3 and then guys fourth one will be for home bottom and fragment will be 4th. Fine guys, so now we have this 4 items. So after this here you have to write get support manager get support fragment manager dot begin transaction and then dot replace r dot id dot frame layout and then semicolon I mean comma then selected dot commit semicolon. Fine guys, so we have to do this code. So simply cut it and then you have to paste that after this bracket. Fine guys, so you have to paste it after this switch statement. So now you can see that it is fine and we are already running true, so it's fine. So just before running the app you have to write one more line and that will be for when the activity will start. So we will already on the profile activity, we will go to the profile activity on start. Fine guys, so that's why I'm writing this line of codes. So get support fragment manager dot begin transaction dot replace r dot id dot frame layout and that is going to be comma then new fragment one dot commit semicolon. Fine guys, so now it's time to run the app and see is it working or not. So guys, in case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section. I will try to reply in next 24 hours. So as you can see that the Gradle build is syncing. Hopefully we should not get any error, but still if you get any error, then let me know in comment section. So guys, you can see that the app is installed successfully and the activity is launched. So let me open, so you can see that this beautiful splash screen, and now we came on this activity. So guys, you can see that this is profile activity. So now we are on this profile automatically. If I will click on it, so we came on this question, and then this is for request, this is for home. Fine. So you can see guys that our app is working absolutely fine. There is no error. So you can see that it is pretty fine. Fine guys. So if I will reopen the app, so if I will open social media app, so here you can see this beautiful animation. Fine guys. So here as you can see that our app is working pretty fine. So guys, in next app, in next tutorial, we will implement, we'll create the XML file for user profile. So then you will be able to store user data and you will be able to update it. Fine guys. So that is going to be a very interesting part. So if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Thank you for watching.